nobody's asking these questions. People are just going along with it. So, yeah, I mean, it shows the trauma and the long-term effects. And you're seeing it now with also suppliers. Like in every industry, I talk to people, everything's backed up. People are overstressed. I mean, it's just like the long-term effects of all this. I mean, we've been saying this since 2020. I mean, we don't even understand the long-term effects of what 2020 did to the humanity.
May I add to that?
Absolutely. Ricky, yep.
I am in San Francisco. You cannot get crazier than and deranged from here. One, seeing less masks, I've not worn masks outside, on the street, I realize how I've been traumatized and how happy I am to see someone's face and to see a smile. Next, the amount of people that claim that they are in health and wellness who are still perpetuating this mask bullshit is a disgrace to health and wellness. I'm in the health and wellness field as a functional medicine consultant, and I try to sustain a healthy life. Yoga teachers, Pilates, massage, all telling me that they are safer. I don't even bother to get into the real facts. And I saw a naked man, except for a loincloth, two guys last week. And I asked him, why are you wearing a mask outside? For safety. So you can maybe take a quicker on the street now. So just want to say that also, I have some, sorry, I'm very upset today. And I have some comments directed to Dr. Judy. Are we thinking about you get into an accident and you get in and you have to go to the emergency? Are they going to tell you you have to get vaccinated? Are they going to tell you have to get a bullshit PCR test? I'm contending with a fibroid, and I've just been told that I have to get a mandatory nasal swab. I told them I have MRSA in my nasal passages. You would think they would know some, you know, just play around with the nasal passage and it'll cause a bloom, a reinfection. That is a very solid, reasonable request. Why are they mandating UCSF? Why do they have their own mandates? How do they decide? It's bullshit. What, I have Epstein-Barr now. Is that good? Am I going to be flagged for that? It's the only virus that exists. It's so retarded. I'm so sick of it. I want to also say that fibroids is a very common thing. What do they do for fibroids? They recommend a hysterectomy because they get $38,000 a pop for castrating 700,000 women. Out of those 700,000, maybe 80% plus are not, you don't requisite removing your entire uterus because Western medicine is compartmentalized. We have doctors that don't know shit about health. It is so frustrating. Okay, thank you for letting me rant. I want to say, if you can clear up, Dr. Judy, I understand that we're doing the clinical trials in 2023. So we are the animals. They actually, in June 12, 2020, had a paper, Current Global Vaccine and Drug Efforts Against Pros and Cons of Bypassing Animal Trials. Where is the equivalent for PETA for humans? They're getting upset for conducting experiments on animals. And we're the animals. Our children are the animals that don't even need a vaccine because they have an immune system. This sorcery is disgusting. So if you can comment on that, I understand that they did try to look for mRNA replication and the ferrets died. And then I noticed that there was a Senate hearing in December of 2020, and this man was talking about therapeutics, and he was labeled an anti. Why? Because as Judy recently discovered and talked about with John Cullen and Jason Goodman, the only way they could get their EUA on their bullshit was if there was no FDA-approved therapeutic. But guess what? Remdesivir is FDA-approved. So what does that mean? That they are violating U.S. code. So I just wanted to reiterate that. Thank you, over and out. Thank you so much.
Well, I appreciate, Mary, and the frustration. I blew up on a call last week at a bunch of doctors and just said, like, wake up. They keep asking me these questions like, oh, what about the new variant? Well, what about a shingle shot? You know, wake up, folks. They've done this all along.